Hi, here is this thing that I have shown in the last episode. I have this unit in store since 15 years and I've bought it in faulty condition. It has about 30 kilograms and it is really, really heavy. So, what is it? It's an Onkyo Grand Integra, the Japanese version AG10. Unfortunately, I've got myself a scratch, which happened most likely in the storage. This is a wonderful unit. I have paid 200 euro, which is really a very cheap and fair price. It's not for sale. I want to repair it, a very exclusive amplifier, which I could never afford otherwise. Oh, I love this map. Wow. Excellent. The top plate is made out of aluminium. Wow. Have a look at that. This is a beautiful top cover. Oh. Wow, crazy. Unbelievable. Twelve thousand microfarads, 80 volts. The power transformer is, extremely large. Here's the power amplifier section. Wow, there are large transistors on this heatsink. Yeah, the amp is going into protect as far as I remember. So I guess one of the amps is faulty. Yeah, which is usually a short on the transistors. There are high quality capacitors everywhere. Seems like everything electrolytic in here is made by Nichicon. Here, I guess, is the phono board. This is one crazy amp. I'm loving it. So, what's underneath here? A little power supply, beautiful. Oh, high quality Muse caps, the green ones. Excellent. And some digital stuff. Okay, and this is what's at the output. And here's a better look at the capacitors. Beautiful. If you are wondering where the fuses are, they are in the left upper corner. Do not remove these two screws here. We are on the rear side and there are connections for everything. Digital stuff, analog, even phono inputs and even video inputs and outputs. Beautiful. Here's a power selector. Wow, this is the bottom side. Beautiful stuff. So let's open this one up here. Check out the feet. These are amazing. Solid aluminium. And what's that? Do we have a large steel chassis? Okay, are you ready for this beautiful moment? Let's go. Wow, that's extreme. That's absolutely crazy. Here's a steel chassis. This, I guess, is to eliminate vibrations. Honestly, I have never seen blue alp spots for, here, yeah, what is it? Bass, treble, balance, I guess. Crazy. Wonderful input boards. No, the caps on the left are not faulty. This is just some sort of a glue. Same here. This is art. Here's the power supply. Wonderful. Guess what? I went through the transistors, I've measured each of them, and they are all fine. Yeah, that's quite interesting. All of the transistors seem fine. I have no shorts or whatsoever. But on every single output and on every single transistor, every single pin, we have the full DC voltage on every pin. So, yeah, that's strange. Any ideas? Let me know, please. Good channel. Well, I have removed every single transistor and I still have 62 volts on the output of this particular channel. So what's wrong here? I have measured at the output coils of the amps and there are 62 volts on every coil DC. On the other hand, on this cable here, this wire harness doesn't look original. Look how ugly this was done. I really doubt that this is original Onkyo. No, look at the cable. That's not original. There's no way this is original. What happened here? The transistors have no fault. But there are still 62 volts DC on the output. I've disconnected all pins. Trust me, I can't show it on the camera. It looks like there is still a connection, but it's not. Trust me. Anyway, there are still 62 volts on every single pin here, on every solder pad here. Why? What's wrong here? Do you have any idea? Please let me know. Thank you. Hi, thanks for watching. Yeah, I was unable to post videos in over 2 weeks. First, I've got sick with fever. This was really very annoying with so much work in my store and at customers. And then lying in bed, knowing I can't do anything. This was the hell, really. Then I had so much stress, so many things to do. Oh, this was ugly. And now I start to have more time. Well, thanks to all my supporters on Patreon. Thanks for keeping your support and for donating and for nice comments and all that stuff. Here is a look at some things here that are on store. We have here a very old Connar oscilloscope. And there is a Zeiss thing, which I don't know what it is. A Benning power supply, which I really would like to see inside. A Siemens thing, long and heavy. A Nicolet oscilloscope. Here is this spectrum analyzer plug-in. A filter made by Siemens. A measuring bridge made by Siemens. A Luxman transistor amplifier. And another one. Both have some faults. A Rode & Schwarz measuring chamber. Tektronix scope. And so on. There are thousands of things. I mean, this is just... this is just one tiny fraction of my store. Absolutely crazy. So yeah, thanks again for watching and see you again soon. New episodes of CPS are coming and I have so many teardowns, teardown videos and repair videos, which I want to produce really soon. Also, I was at a lost place in Croatia in last summer and this footage is lying around since ages. It is very interesting and I will post a video soon. Bye.